In darkness they came. Their destination, the Games Academy somewhere out at sea. Their mission, to become games playing legends and to crack the challenge of Games Master.
Master Team Championship. You've joined us here in the caretaker's furnace room for the second heat, where three more teams are competing for a place in the semi-finals, where they can win, if they get through to the finals that is, not only the coveted title of Games Master Team of Champions, but a whole bunch of Mega Mungus video prizes. Let's hope the teams are on form, because we got the freshest new games we could find, and the teams are lucky if they get to see the car, let alone play it as practice. So, let's go and meet these teams who are going to play tonight's challenges. Over here, this way. The red team have been let out of their cell, and they're the Leighton Wizards, aren't they? Leighton Wizards?
Yep.
Hello, good evening. So, who's your team captain?
Me, Leon.
Leon?
Hassan.
Hassan?
Paul.
Paul, so you're the team captain, Leon?
Yep.
What would you say that your team's strong game is?
Strong at everything. We're just typically the best.
Yeah? You're going to be the best every game we've got tonight?
Every game.
All right, well, good luck. Let's go on and meet the green team. This way. Okay, this is the culture crew. Excuse me, young man. Let's get through it. Culture crew from London. Here they are. And their team captain. Come on, tell us your name. What's your name?
Isis.
Isis, and what's your name?
Anthony.
Anthony? Tom. Okay, Isis, you heard the other team. They reckon they were going to be good at every kind of challenge we got on tonight's show. What do you reckon your team's going to be good at?
You see what you're getting the best.
We're getting the best, yeah? Is that right, lads? You're the best?
Yep.
Yeah, you're going to kick the other teams up?
You know it.
All right, well, there you go. There you have it fresh from your very own mouth. Right, let's go and meet the final team, the yellow team, this way. Excuse me. Okay, through here, we've got the yellow team. They're called the Gits, and they're from Milton Keynes. Sounds a bit ominous. Okay, what's your name, team captain?
Steve.
Team captain, Steve?
Sunil.
Sunil?
Bradley.
Bradley. Do you want to tell us why you're called the Gits, Steve?
You tell you.
Go on, Brad,
We're the Gaming International Team Specialists.
Oh, Gaming International Team Specialists. Well, let's hope you are specialists. Now, each team captain is going to choose a player from his team to play a challenge in his or her specialist field. Let's go over to the Games Master, find out exactly what this challenge is going to be.
For tonight's platform game, I've chosen the magical and mysterious Sky Blazers for the Super Nintendo. Guiding your character through the ancient landscape, you must collect 50 diamonds in the quickest time. Shooting or punching the cloaked villains along the way will reveal more diamonds and prevent you from losing a single life that I've granted you for this task. I'll award 5 points to the winner, 2 to the runner-up, and nothing to the loser.
So, the challenge is Sky Blazers. Leon from the Wizards, he's in position. He's got to collect 50 diamonds in the quickest possible time that he can. Leon, start your challenge. What's that, Dave?
Those are the baddies. He's got to kill those. Those baddies will often leave something behind, like a diamond or a power-up. The power-ups are no good to him. That big diamond, that's worth 10. So he wants to be looking out for those. Power-ups gun, which are good for recuperating your energy, but he's not worried about that. He's on a time challenge. That was another big 10 he got up there. He took a knock. There's an energy bar up in the top left-hand corner.
He's
with four notches on it.
So far.
If those run, Dave, he loses all four, he's going to die. He's got 46 diamonds. He's doing very well. There's a big 10 up there. He gets his bad guy.
He's got
59 diamonds.
That's 35 seconds. That's the end of the challenge there for Leon. Leon scored a very respectable 35 seconds there. That's the time that the other two teams are going to have to beat. Now, Steve from the Gits is in position. Okay, Steve, start your challenge.
Okay, so off Steve goes, leaping up the walls, killing the bad guys early on. That's the thing, collect the little diamonds they leave behind. Build up all the little diamonds and go for those big ones when they appear.
Always
landing on the spikes. He wants to be very careful.
That's
the man clinging onto the side of the walls. But if you make him leap off at the wrong time, he's going to hit
another
the spikes.
Big diamond
That's
there.
A good leap. You've got the tennis back on the spikes again. The energy bar's down. He's gone.
That's it. He's out of the challenge.
He's out of the challenge.
He's out of the challenge. Diamonds. He didn't even get a time, so the yellows don't qualify for that one, that's for sure. Okay, Isis, the team captain of the culture crew, she's in position. Okay then, Isis, start your challenge there.
Isis has gone pairing
on.
Once again, she's going to kill these early baddies, pick up what they leave behind.
She
should know now where the diamonds are because she saw the other guys getting them.
Isis
has got the 10. She's hit no spike. She's taken a bit of damage. If you look at the energy bar from the top left, that was Stitch's mistake. She wants to get up there and get that diamond. She missed out on 10. That's a terrible thing to do.
25 seconds.
As long as she gets 50 without diamonds, she's going to be okay. She's missing a lot of diamonds. There's another one she's left behind. Her energy bar, she's only got one hit left. And she hasn't got enough diamonds. She's got 48. She's safe. Even if she dies, that's it. Her challenge is over. 49 diamonds.
Well, she's only got 49 diamonds. I think that puts them into second place. Well, let's go and check out the scoreboard. The Gits, they died, and so they get no points. That means they've got zero on the scoreboard. The Culture Crew, well, they did get 49 diamonds, so they get 2 points. But in the lead at the moment is the red team, the Leighton Wizards. They got their full 50 diamonds in 35 seconds. They've got 5 points. Yeah! Okay, the teams are getting ready for their next challenge. While they do that, you sit back and enjoy the review.
It's time to wake up and smell the hummus. He's lost his sword and now he's got a cape. Our hero, Aladdin, has made his way from the Mega Drive to the Super Nintendo in a platform romp through 6 magical worlds.
Aladdin on the stairs doesn't really live up to its Mega Drive rival, mainly because the animation just isn't there.
It's good. There's some entertaining bits in it. I like the carpet ride. The only trouble is that it's too easy.
It's one of the best platformers of the year. It's smooth, it looks good, and the animation is worthy of Walt himself.
Space helmets on for this, the first game on Atari's new super console, the Jaguar. Flying your craft through loads of alien worlds, collecting, blasting, and generally looking cool is what it's all about in this 3D game of discovery.
Cybermorph's the game that's packaged along with the new Atari Jaguar console. And believe me, it's very, very good indeed. If this is the state of Jaguar games at the moment, then, well, we've got a lot to look forward to in the future.
The game's, well, sort of like Starwing with knobs on, but it's good. It's very fast. The shoot-em-up action's excellent.
It looks the business, and it should sell Jaguars, but in terms of playability, it leaves a bit to be desired.
Are you wondering how we at GamesMaster get games so far in advance? Well, we get sent hundreds of prototype chips that look something like this, which eventually end up in the shops as fully developed games cartridges. For the rest of the series, GamesMaster will exclusively preview the most exciting and, as yet, unreleased games for our new feature, In Development. And we kick off this week with the very first pictures of the arcade game you've all been waiting for, Mortal Kombat 2. The game is even bigger this time round, with 12 fighters for you to choose from.
Here it is! Mortal Kombat 2! More characters! 3 times more images! More secret moves! More battlegrounds! More hidden surprises!
Sonya's gone, but in her place is Melina with her truly explosive death move. Other newcomers include Big Bad Baracus, a kind of Mexican cowboy Jax, and Kum Lao. Meanwhile, the boffins at Probe Software are hard at work on the console version. Stand by for pictures of that very soon.
Okay, that was the review, letting you know which games are worth your hard-earned cash or not. Right, we've come to the second challenge of tonight's competition. Let's go over to the Games Master, find out what this challenge is all about.
My mystery game this evening is the bizarrely titled Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine for the Sega Mega Drive. Our contestants must collect as many beans as possible in 45 seconds by joining together groups of 4 or more beans of the same color in any formation. Once again, 5 points will be awarded for the winning team, 2 to the runner-up, and nothing to the loser.
So the game is Mean Beans. Bradley of the Gits is sitting in position. They've got it all to play for because the Yellows are in last position at the moment. So he's got to collect as many beans as he possibly can.
45.
In 45. Okay, Bradley, start your challenge.
Oh, Bradley goes, as the little beans drop, the idea is to get all the beans the same colour together like that. Once you've got 4 together, they disappear and you get 4 chalked up on your scoreboard. If 4 disappear, that gap will be filled by other beans. That's a 5er. That's very good. That's 9 beans. As they disappear, it's very much like Tetris. Other beans will fill their place. If those beans match up the same colour, then those will be added to your
squad. Right, so he's got 13 beans so far, yeah?
13 beans so far. That was a nice one. That was a 6er. Now he's up to 8.
Time's ticking away. 15 seconds left.
Very, very... Oh, that was a beauty.
Exactly.
He's got loads then. together. Once you got four 10, more of the same colour, 9, they will all disappear. 8, number 7, beans in the middle 6, of the screen.
5,
in pink, he's got
4,
24 beans
3,
so far. He's got
2,
last
1,
can he get the
one.
Yes, he's got
stop
last
your
one.
Challenge!
Seconds. Now we've got Anthony up of the Culture Crew. Dave, what's the lowdown on Anthony then?
Well, Anthony's claim to game fame is completing Mortal Kombat in 30 minutes, but we wonder, is he a Nancy Boy easy level player?
Yeah, oh, Dave's egging the players on as usual. Okay then, Anthony, start your challenge!
Anthony's straight off with his beans. As the beans come cascading down, once again he's looking to
he's
get
well
lines
away.
Of
spinning
four.
Around now.
He's setting them up, you see. He's got two lines of three and a line of two. He's going to get those greens down there.
Good
for
move.
A line of four. The idea is to match up the beans, the coloured beans, in four or more. Now that's going to be one, you see.
He's up
four.
To eight.
It doesn't matter how you put the four together, as long as there are four of the same colour.
Right, diagonally, horizontally, it really don't matter, no.
Anyway, as long as there are four coloured beans touching each other, then you'll get the score. There you go, that's another one.
Okay, he's coming
he's
up to 30 seconds.
So
30 seconds
he's
gone. He's got to get going. 16,
there's
that's not too high.
Him. There's nothing on for him at all. There's a green one.
He's Whisk coming up to
down.
5 seconds left.
That's 20.
5, 4, 20, 3, 20, 2, 20, 1. Stop the challenge. Stop the challenge. And you've got 25 beans. Not so good. All right, then, next up, we've got Paul from the Wizards. Is he going to need to use some magic on this one, Dave?
Paul only just escaped through an audition, so it could be tight.
Right, it's going to go either way. The player's in position. Start your challenge!
So off goes Paul,
here we
getting
go.
His first beans down. It's very important to place these beans just right and leave all your options open.
Yeah.
Now he's got a yellow
nice
on.
Nice line of yellows
there. There we go. Yellow
he's
for the first to go. He's got four beans. He's got the reds there, but he's only got a line of three. He's blocked them in a little bit. That's four gone, four blue gone. That's eight now. That's nice. He's got five
hey,
beans together.
13 now.
Beautiful. He's got 13
24
beans.
Seconds gone.
Doing very well. He's setting up some yellows. He has another
yeah,
four.
That's another four.
Doing very,
30
very
seconds
well.
Gone. What's his score? 17.
Now, yeah, there's another four going with the blue.
Oh, very
he's
nifty.
Doing extremely well. He's got a red. That's very clever.
He's down to 5 seconds. Five.
That's the
four,
green gone.
Three.
Oh, he's very tight. He's got
two.
Five. No, he needs to get those reds there. He just
stop the challenge.
Five is the tie.
We've got 25 beans. We've got two teams with 25 beans. That means they might be awarded 2 points each. But let's go over to the scoreboard. The Wizards won the first round, so they got five there. They came second in this heat, so they've got seven altogether. The Gits, they came nowhere in the first round, but they won this challenge, so they've got five. And the Culture Crew got two in the first heat and two in this heat. That means they've only got four. Doesn't sound too good. Let's go and meet the teams. Come on. Well done, Gits. Yeah, well done. Ah, here we are, the losing team, Culture Crew. You got blown out. Isis, are you gutted?
No, why should I be?
No, all them mega prizes.
Wizard of Oz is going to be right behind us.
The Wizards are going to be right behind us. Well, she's still intimidating the teams. It's all getting wound up here.
Yeah,
all right, I think we're going to have to get the caretaker to take this lot away, innit? Yeah. Expel them! Expel them! No mercy! They're a ruthless crowd. Okay, in the second half, we've got the Gits and the Wizards battling out for a place in the semi-finals. We've also got the second part of our FIFA Soccer Challenge, so stay tuned for that one. Last week, you would have seen Vinnie Jones and Les Ferdinand battling it out on our FIFA Soccer Challenge. Well, this week, we've got two football stars of an equal calibre. Please put your hands together for Chelsea captain Dennis Wise and a man with an amazing 67 England caps to his name, Liverpool's very own John Barnes! Now, John, Little Bird tells me that you've had a bit of practice on the FIFA Soccer Challenge, no?
Never seen it before. My son's had a few tries, but I haven't played it yet.
No? You've just been using your natural flair and ability?
Well, I'm going for a nil all draw against Dennis, I think.
Yeah, a nil all draw?
I fence myself on penalties.
Yeah, it's all right. That'd be good if you had that. What do you reckon, Dennis?
I'm looking forward to penalties. I'm not a bad penalty taker, so I'm looking forward to it. How about that?
All right, then, well, good luck on your challenge, Des. Let's go over to the Games Master, find out a bit more about it.
Here we go. Yes. For the second round of my FIFA Soccer Championship, I decided to go pan-European. The teams Italy and Germany should provide an evenly matched coupling of Latin flamboyance and Aryan precision. It's all to play for.
So, John Barnes is playing Italy and Dennis Wise is playing Germany. The winner of this week's FIFA Soccer Challenge is going to come back next week to play Vinnie Jones in the final, where one of them will win the fabulous Games Master Golden Joystick. OK, guys, start your challenge!
So John Barnes and Italy,
they're away.
Kicking from left to right in the blue shirts. Dennis White to Germany.
Yes,
the white
shirts, Italy. Right John Barnes.
John Barnes was
straight off, shot bit of action there. Go on, Dennis.
Oh,
Dennis pushes back in the field.
Away.
Moves on.
Now Dennis
passes it down. He's number 19.
Oh, John's
16 picks it up.
Dennis has got a long
shot. Great try to make the natural flair and ability of John Barnes.
That's going out to the wing. His player run past the ball.
For England,
oh, no, it's a goal. That's it. That's the first
goal.
1-0 to John Barnes in Italy.
Dennis,
what a corner of a goal. Outside the area.
Dennis will not be happy about that. They love John Barnes.
Plenty of time. Yeah,
man.
Plenty of time.
Barnes making another break.
John's relying on those long shots a little bit. Maybe it's flattering him a little bit because those shots aren't going to do any real damage. What am I saying? That's disastrous.
Still going mad for John Barnes.
And who can blame them? He's totally bossed this game.
All right, Dennis kicks off.
Dennis Wise is taking
a long. No one there peeing up.
Oh,
it's a goal! It's a blinder of a goal!
From the middle of the park. Dennis,
I think
just
that was a bit of a shock there for John Barnes.
I think it was a shock for Dennis. I don't think he really knew what he was doing. The goalies are not being controlled by the computer, they're being controlled by the competitors.
Barnes kicks off.
So sometimes they just, the players just make the move to the side by mistake, and that's just long enough for the ball to find the back of the net.
And that's what the aim of the game is.
Game on now.
Get the ball in the
back. With another screamer. 3-1.
John Barnes' player's freaking out.
I think we're going to have a goal feast here.
Yes.
3-1 is only the
more
first
goals
half.
Than you know what to do with.
And whilst his keepers are very safe when they come and collect the ball,
Dennis,
they look dodgy with long shots, and that's the end of the half.
Oh, that's the end of the first half.
3-1 to John Barnes.
3-1 to John Barnes.
What a good half that was.
What
John totally took control.
Riveting half that was.
Dennis is really going to have to get down in the
right,
trenches
Dennis
and battle his way through this one.
Keep him straight there, John Barnes.
Not with shots like that.
He's really got some great moves on it this game, hasn't he?
You get overhead kicks, diving headers, everything. John with another long one.
Kick.
The keeper just kicked that one straight out.
Nuts it on, hits
that's
it on.
To the offside, but he can't pass back to the keeper.
Oh, that's beautiful.
It's John Barnes. 4-1 to John Barnes in Italy.
Oh, dear, Dennis. Oh, dear, Dennis.
This is turning into a whitewash. Come on, Dennis, let's have some battling.
Let's have some battling.
Trying a nice long shot again.
Oh.
John Barnes seems to have got wise to those now. The keeper's always there, always covering it. Nice long ball. Once again, it's John Barnes in possession.
Yo!
Right down to the foot of the post, the keeper got there.
Chips it back
it
out.
Wide.
John's putting the pressure on again.
Once again, John hits the ball back
there,
in.
No.
Dennis is battling out. He's trying to get it out.
Good bit of defense.
And this is dangerous. John Barnes on the edge of the area. Broke
on.
Shot in.
Oh, it's a
beautiful
tackle. Nice starting tackle.
Didn't get possession. That's the Germans away. God, there's
Paul. He's away again. Defense is there.
Speed, he's got it. Like it was past the keeper. Dennis is trying now. He's getting a lot more attacking opportunities than he had before. But he just doesn't seem to be able to find a way past the keeper.
Well, that's it.
It's all over.
Italy wins.
The game.
John Barnes. Go
4-1 to John Barnes and Italy.
Let's get the lads on stage and have a quick word with them. Oh, well done, John. Okay. So, Dennis, 4-1. A bit of a hammering. What went wrong?
The goalkeeper didn't know what he was doing, I think. He was all over the gaff.
He was all over the shop, wasn't he?
Always blame the goalkeeper.
Is that the best thing to do, is it?
I was a bit lucky, though. I had a few lucky shots.
Well, it's a good result. 4-1. You must be well chuffed.
Well, we're looking forward to the final now.
Yes, that's right. You'll be playing Vinnie Jones in our final next week.
All right. I look forward to that.
Yes, so will we. All right, then. Let's have a big round of applause for our two contestants. Dennis Wise. Our two final teams will be playing their final challenge to see which one goes through the championship semis. So, while they limber up, why don't you sit back and enjoy the consultation zone?
Welcome to my secret bonus room. Who wants to be the first to power up their game-playing knowledge?
Games Master, I'm working machines for the Mega Drive. I feel the need for speed. Can you help?
Ah, I love a bit of speed myself. Now, there's a superb cheat on this game that will allow you to rocket away from the opposition. While playing, press Start to pause the game and type in the following code. Up, down, A, B, left, right, C. Now, unpause the game and you'll find your car is now operating in turbo. Start your engines.
Cheers, Games Master.
My pleasure.
Games Master, I'm Ren and Stimpy for the SNES. The big beaver, it keeps killing me. I can't beat him. What can I do?
It's very simple. All you have to do to kill our beaver friend is to pick up the teeth that are located around his mouth and throw them at him when he's in range. Repeat this process, and you'll soon get rid of him. Happy now?
Oh, thanks, Games Master.
That's all, I think, for tonight.
Oi, Games Master, what about me?
Yes, what is it? Marisha is rustling up a little something for me. I can't keep her waiting.
I keep losing all my shields on Donk on the Amiga. Do you have any cheats for it?
Okay, try this. At the end of the level, when the klaxon sounds and the screen turns red, type in able to cheat. Now press function key 1 and your shields will be replenished.
Thanks very much, Games Master.
Now, I really must go and recharge my energy supplies. See you anon.
A few more queries firmly answered by the Games Master there in the consultation zone. Now, we've got two teams left competing for a place in the championship semi-finals. We've got the Wizards over here on my right, team captain Leon. Who's taking part in this challenge?
Hassan.
Hassan's taking part in this challenge. Yep. It's a beat-em-up, Hassan. You good at them?
Yes.
Yes, you are. Yes. Quietly confident. And what about you, Steve? Who's going to be battling out for you?
Sunil.
Sunil, yeah? Confident?
Damn right. Yeah, damn right.
It's going to be an easy victory.
It's going to be an easy victory. Where do you have it? There's lots of friction between the teams. Remember, there's no points for this challenge. Whoever wins gets straight through to the semi-finals. Games Master, give us the info.
The beat-em-up I've chosen sees the return of those old stars, the Ninja Turtles and their adversaries, in the game Tournament Titles for the Super Nintendo. The winner of this head-to-head contest was the first to take two rounds off his opponent in a feat of fighting action, a special move for Kempi. Cowabunga, man.
So, the game is Turtles Tournament Fighters. There's three rounds of beat-em-up action. We've got Sunil from the Gits. He's going to be playing Leonardo. And also, we've got Hassan from the Wizards. He's going to be playing Shredder. The team that wins, they're the ones who go through to the semi-finals. So, OK, guys, get battling. Start your challenge.
There we go. Sunil and Leonardo. Leonardo's the green turtle, of course.
Yes, there he is. That's the turtle. You couldn't miss him.
Shredder.
Of course, Sunil.
Oh, it's a beautiful flash kick.
And that both Hassan getting Sunil. Thrown all over the place.
That's his special move. That's his sword whirlwind. And that's his energy bolt as well.
Chips him over. Got some go on,
really
Shredder.
Wicked special moves. The bar swatch of the energy bars up the top. And that's it for Shredder.
Yeah,
oh, no,
it's
not
too
nearly down.
It's special all over the place.
It's going to be over. That's it.
Good move from Sunil.
Down, one up, Sunil and Leonardo.
Okay, so it's one up for Sunil and Leonardo. As Dave quite rightly said, let's get straight on with the second round.
Like I said, the thing to watch is the energy bars right at the top, those yellow bars. When they go all red,
come on,
that's the energy's run out and that fight is nearly finished.
Come on,
and Sunil, as I predicted, does seem to be far too powerful for Shredder and Hassan. He's got all the special moves and there's nothing Shredder and Hassan can do about this. This is very one-sided. He's trying to fight, but he just hasn't got what
come
it takes. He's flashing. Shredder's nearly gone. It's all over. Sunil's won. What an easy victory.
Okay, Sunil done the business there. He's battered Hassan in two rounds. Let's go and have a word with the Git. Okay, let's see what the teams are saying, shall we? Leon is not a happy man. There's the team captain of Riz. Come here, you two. Come on, come on. Hassan, man, what went wrong?
I've never seen that game before.
You did quite well then, considering. Unlucky about that. So, yeah, you got your team through to the semi-finals, please?
Yeah, for some. But, yeah. I mean, it's just that I was just too good at Street Fighter 2 and the moves are too similar.
Yeah, they're very similar, the moves.
You know,
well,
so, yeah.
There you have it. Well done anyway, guys. That means the Gits are through.
Away.
Yep, shake hands. Very sporting. Let's give all our contestants a cheer, eh, team? Come on, eh? Okay. Now, next week we've got the final of our FIFA Soccer Challenge with John Barnes and Vinnie Jones, no less. So you'll have to tune in to check that one out. Also, we'll have three more teams competing for a place in the Games Master Team Championship semi-finals. So come back to us next week for that one. So we'll see you then, I hope. Bye.
Yeah!